What's going on, guys? It's Quazy Dog here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the SmartMi Air Purifier. Now, I've spent about a month or so daily driving the SmartMi Air Purifier, so let's see if it's worth all of your hard-earned money, or if it's just blowing smoke. All that and more, right after a word from today's video sponsor. Are you sick and tired of getting emails like these? What about worrying whether or not your passwords have been leaked or compromised? Well, that's where the Security Key NFC by Yubico can help. The Security Key NFC is a hardware authentication solution that adds an additional layer of protection to your account. That way, if a hacker gets a hold of your username and password, they won't be able to get into your accounts without your YubiKey. Featuring both USB-A and NFC support, the Security Key by Yubico is ready to safeguard anything from email and social media accounts to your most important accounts like banking or business applications. Learn more by visiting the URL in the video description below, and thank you to Yubico for sponsoring today's video. Now, the SmartMi Air Purifier is a pretty self-explanatory device, given, of course, it's an air purification system, as the name implies. So I think the first question here should be, what exactly are the benefits of a product like this, and is it something that you should actually consider? Believe it or not, the air pollution inside your home could be up to 5 times the amount found in the outside open air, and given we've all been spending more time inside over the last year, that can certainly add up. For me, I'm in the middle of a Canadian winter with closed doors and windows, and a rarely cleaned forced air furnace for heat, plus I have animals running around like crazy. With that being said, over the last couple of months of running the SmartMi Air Purifier in my office, I've definitely noticed a change in my personal asthma symptoms, as well as a difference in the air quality readout from the SmartMi app. This is mainly accomplished by using the medical grade 360 degree HEPA H13 filter with antimicrobial coating. This filter is said to last up to 6 to 12 months before you need to change it out, but more on that later. Measuring 14 inches tall and just under 9 inches in diameter, it's big enough to purify an average-sized living space while still maintaining a small enough footprint to fit on most end tables or shelving units. Taking a visual tour around the SmartMi Air Purifier from the top to the bottom, we'll first notice the display and the upwards-mounted exhaust system. This display is pretty simple in design, while still containing a good level of information and functions. Controlling the device is as simple as touching the screen for power on and off, fan controls, and timer settings, while the display itself indicates mode inputs and contaminant readouts. As for the exhaust, well, it's just that. It's an upward-mounted exhaust that takes air from the bottom, purifies it, and kicks it out of the top for you to breathe. Midway down, we have the leather carrying handle, which is helpful for transporting the unit from room to room. Although the unit itself is small for a home appliance and weighs just under 7 pounds, its sleek body stylings and machined aluminum aren't doing any favors for grip, so that handle is very nice to have. Next is the machined intake inlets covering the bottom of the unit, as well as the laser particle sensor. This is where the contaminants are measured and then pulled into the unit for filtration. There's really not much to say here. The inlet looks clean and stylish, and the machined metal is rounded off as to not be a danger to the touch. Rounding off the surroundings at the bottom is the power inlet. Again, not much to see here, but I do appreciate its flush design. Lastly, we have the underside of the unit itself. Giving this a twist will allow you to access the inner workings of the SmartMi Air Purifier, and we as well get our first look at the filter inside. So this filter is a 360 degree H13 HEPA filter. H13 HEPA filters are considered medical grade filters thanks to their ability to capture 99.95% of contaminants found within our air. There's also not much maintenance needed here, other than replacing the filter every 6 to 12 months depending on your use case, but don't worry, the app will also remind you when it's time to get a new one. Speaking of the app experience itself, I had mentioned this was a smart device, so let's take a look at the SmartMi application. From the top down, you'll be able to see which SmartMi device you're actively using, the quality of the air being expelled with the unit measuring both PM10 and PM2.5 levels, controls for the power and mode selection, and an estimated filter lifespan indicator for both filter percentage and an estimated remaining day indicator before you need a new filter. Aside from using it within the application itself, the SmartMi Air Purifier is also compatible with Google Assistant, Amazon Alexa, an Apple HomeKit, meaning it's going to integrate easily within whatever ecosystem you have with your current smart devices. So with all that being said, does this actually work? Well, the answer is yes, I honestly think it does. I personally leave my unit in automatic mode, which uses the laser particle sensor to adjust the intensity of the cleaning at all times of use. Now, for the most part, it stays pretty quiet. However, I do find mornings after my forced air has been running all night and my office doors have been shut, it can get a little loud when it first ramps up. If this bothers me, I just switch it to manual mode and turn the actual fan setting down until I'm ready to let it ramp up again. Even at max setting, it's not overly noisy, but for me, my optimum sitting area is about 2 feet away from the unit itself, and it's positioned very, very close to ear level, so I can notice it at times. Since using the device, my air quality measurements have gone from poor at first use to good, and then to excellent shortly after using it on the daily within my office, and I can really feel the difference, as silly as that sounds. Personally, I wish I had have actually cataloged a baseline measurement before I started using this. However, looking at the application, my PM10 is measuring very low, and my PM2.5 is typically at 1 after using the device, which Google tells me are both really good numbers for air measurement quality. In closing, the SmartMi Air Purifier is something I truthfully did not think that I needed until SmartMi jumped into my email inbox and offered to send this out for unbiased testing. Since using it, I'm strongly considering picking up another one for my main living area upstairs. For more information on the SmartMi Air Purifier, as well as pricing and availability, please be sure to check out the links within the video description. As always, my name is QueasyDog, you guys have been awesome, and we'll catch you all in the next one. Take care.